The Principle of Honor. Kingdom Pattern. Principle: it is a comprehensive and fundamental law, doctrine, or assumption, a rule or code of conduct. Honor: it is to think highly of, or treat someone with admiration and respect, it is giving special recognition to someone. To honor is to regard with great respect, or to bestow high value to something or to someone. Honor comes from the heart, and it has the power to unlock doors. In God's kingdom, honor is a principle which has value of crucial significance. Honor comes from the heart, and it is expressed through our conducts and behavior. Humility is the principal element of honor. Honor is a key that unlocks blessings. Who to honor? 1. Jehovah. The person before any other to give honor to is the Almighty God. The Bible instructs us to ascribe honor to God from our heart, and not just from your lips. God deserves to be honored by all His creations, and He also honors those who honor Him. 1 Samuel 2 verse 30. Therefore the Lord God of Israel says, I said indeed that your house and the house of your father would walk before me forever. But now the Lord says, far be it from me, for those who honor me I will honor, and those who despise me shall be lightly esteemed. 2. God's Word. The Bible require us to honor the Word of God, His principles which are His instructions to us. When a person honors God's Word, he also obeys and lives by the Word. Matthew 4 verse 4. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. 3. Honor men. The Bible implore us to give honor to whom honor is due. Honor is a key that makes door to open among men. We are to give appropriate honor to those who it is due, to government, the church, and to one another. 1 Peter 2 verse 17. Honor all people. Love the brotherhood. Fear God. Honor the King. Romans 13 verse 2. Therefore whoever resists the authority resists the ordinance of God, and those who resist will bring judgment on themselves. We have to honor men in leadership, even if their use of authority is harsh. We honor them because of their position and not for their behavior. Even though not all authorities are upright, but we must know that honoring all authority is the will of God. However, authorities that are evil, or leading people to disobey God cannot earn our obedience, as long as what they want us to do amounts to disobedience to Jehovah our God. Read 1 Peter 2 verse 13 to 15, and 1 Peter 2 verse 18 to 19. Romans 13 verse 1. Let every soul be subject to the governing authorities. For there is no authority except from God, and the authorities that exist are appointed by God. Categories of honor to men. 1. Civil and governmental authorities. 1 Peter 2 verse 13 to 15. Therefore submit yourselves to every ordinance of man for the Lord's sake, whether to the king as supreme, or to governors, as to those who are sent by him for the punishment of evildoers and for the praise of those who do good. For this is the will of God, that by doing good you may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men. We are to honor people in position of authority, even if we do not agree with them. We are not honoring the person but the position that person occupy. Read Romans 13 verse 1 to 7, and Acts 23 verse 5. How do we honor them? We honor them by praying for them, 1 Timothy 2 verse 1 to 2. We honor them by showing them respect. Acts 2 verse 4. We honor them by showing obedient attitude towards them, Romans 13 verse 7. We honor them by not speaking hurtful or untrue comments about them. 1 Samuel 26 verse 9. 2. Social authorities. Colossians 3 verse 22 to 24. Bondservants, obey in all things your masters according to the flesh, not with eye service, as men pleasers, but in sincerity of heart, fearing God. And whatever you do, do it heartily, as to the Lord and not to men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the reward of the inheritance, for you serve the Lord Christ. Those in the category of social authority comprises of our employers, our teachers, and any other positions that have social authority over us. How do we show honor to them? We honor them by obeying their instructions. Titus 3 verse 1. We honor them by willfully doing what we are asked to do as best as one can. We honor them by doing what we are asked to do as doing unto the Lord. 3. Family authorities. Ephesians 6 verse 1-3. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth. How do we honor those in authority in this category? Wives should honor their husbands by treating them with respect, Ephesians 5 verse 22-23. Husbands must honor their wives as weaker vessels, by loving their wives as themselves, which includes being polite and respectful. 1 Peter 3 verse 7, Ephesians 5 verse 21, and Ephesians 5 verse 33. Men must honor the opposite sex with dignity and respect. Even unmarried women, 1 Peter 4 verse 8-9, Titus 3 verse 2. Children must honor their parents by being obedient, respectful, and loving them. 1 Peter 5 verse 5, Ephesians 6 verse 2, and Exodus 20 verse 12. 4. Spiritual authorities. Those in this category include those in leadership positions in the church, those in the fivefold ministry, or other Christian ministries. How do we honor those in authority in this category? We honor them by doing what we are asked to do as doing unto the Lord. Hebrews 13 verse 17. We honor them by financial support, 1 Timothy 5 verse 17-19. We honor them by showing obedient attitude towards them. Ephesians 6 verse 1. We honor them by not criticizing and speaking evil of them. Psalm 105 verse 15. 5. Fellow brethren. We are to honor one another. We should no longer view one another according to our natural distinctions, white or black, rich or poor, but as new creation, children of the Most High God, just as God sees us. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 16-17. Therefore, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even though we have known Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation, old things have passed away, behold, all things have become new. How do we show honor to one another? We honor one another by being polite to one another, 1 Peter 3 verse 8. We honor one another by paying attention and listening to one another, James 1 verse 19. We honor one another by keeping our commitments and promises to one another, Matthew 5 verse 37. We honor one another by serving one another. Colossians 3 verse 23, Matthew 7 verse 12. We honor one another by keeping to time concerning our appointments and meetings with one another. 1 John 2 verse 5. The advantage of honoring harsh leadership. We receive blessing from the Lord when we honor men in leadership, even if they are harsh or ungodly. In so doing we commit our case into God's hands, who is a just God. He will in turn reward us with blessing for not repaying evil with evil, and obedience to his word. However, we should never obey any directive that is contrary to the word of God, which means rebellion to God. Read 1 Peter 3 verse 9, Daniel 3 verse 1-2. Ways to honor God. Honor is a very important law of the kingdom of God, and the principle of honor is meticulously entrenched in it. God honors those who honor him. Honor comes from the heart and is expressed in action. God does not accept honor from the lips while action is contrary. 1 Samuel 2 verse 30. Therefore the Lord God of Israel says, I said indeed that your house and the house of your father would walk before me forever. But now the Lord says, Far be it from me, for those who honor me I will honor, and those who despise me shall be lightly esteemed. 1. You can honor God with your body. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 19 to 20. Or do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have from God, and you are not your own? For you were bought at a price, therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. 2. You can honor God with your finances. Proverbs 3 verse 9 to 10, honor the Lord with your possessions, and with the first fruits of all your increase, so your barns will be filled with plenty, and your vats will overflow with new wine. Read also Deuteronomy 8 verse 17 to 20, and Psalm 15 verse 5. 3. Honor God with your obedience. Deuteronomy 5 verse 33. You shall walk in all the ways which the Lord your God has commanded you, that you may live and that it may be well with you, and that you may prolong your days in the land which you shall possess. Read also Isaiah 1 verse 19, and John 14 verse 15. 4. Honor God by giving Him your best. God wants us to honor Him by serving Him with all of our hearts, and with everything we have. Read Proverbs 27 verse 18, Malachi 1 verse 6 to 7, and Colossians 3 verse 23. 5. Honor God by worshiping Him from your heart. John 4 verse 24, God is spirit, and those who worship Him must worship in spirit and truth. 6. Believing the Word of God. We honor God when we believe His Word. God is pleased with us when we have faith in Him, and rewards us accordingly. Hebrews 11 verse 6, but without faith it is impossible to please Him, for he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. If we sow the seed of honor, we will enjoy the harvest that honor produces. Therefore, we should apply the principle of honor in our walk with God, and without doubt we will experience marvelous growth. The good news. The gospel in a nutshell. Human inherited sin and sinful nature as a result of the sinful disobedience of the first human, Adam and Eve, and the punishment for sin is death, which means separation from God, the source of life. Romans 3:23, we cannot earn our salvation. For this reason Jesus Christ came into the world fully God and fully man. He perfectly obeyed God's law and perfectly fulfilled God's will. He died in our place and as our substitute, paying for our sins. He rose from the dead on the third day and ascended into heaven. He will one day return to the earth to establish His kingdom. If you truly repent from sinful ways, believe and accept Jesus Christ in your heart as Lord and Savior, you will be saved from judgment and spend eternity with God. Remember, Jesus is coming soon. Are you ready? Be the first to know when new videos are published. Please like and follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Click the notification bell beside the subscribe button to be notified of new releases. Kingdom Pattern at www.youtube.com. Crossway Christian Ministries 2 at gmail.com. This is Kingdom Pattern, a ministry of Crossway Christian Ministries.